I think it's a daredevil kind of look. You know, he's very young. A 20-year-old boy with the heart of a devil. And as you can see, honestly speaking, the confidence in the look is very ridiculous.
Say good afternoon, first men, members of CMO, ladies and gentlemen. It has become expedient and necessary for us to have this press conference because of the recent happenings and what we have been seeing on the media. For the past 3 days, there's been, I will call it rumor, that has been going around that the prime suspect, Frank Edward Akpan, in the murder of Nyobong Umorin, and he has committed suicide in police cell. They even gave details up to the essence that he used his trouser, that I don't know anywhere in the world where suspects are put in the cells with his trouser, that he committed suicide using the trouser to tie his hand himself. I've been inundated with several calls from all over the world. As if police decided to bungle a direct case of murder. And that's why we have decided to call for this press conference, so that you can see him. The man who is said to be dead is sitting down here, and maybe you'll be able to interact with him too. It's most unfortunate that the social media that is supposed to be an advantage to the police as well has become a tool that is being used to vilify even the police and the government. It's most unfortunate. You all can see him, he's seated here. He's not dead. He's very much alive, hale and heavy. Well, you can recall that this whole incident started with the job Umorin was seeking to have from Akpan. And unfortunately, the whole thing went sour. The case was first reported as a case of suspected kidnapping. While on the trail of the so-called kidnappers, they went. ICT people went into the media because Instagram was used to facilitate their meeting. And at the end of the day, pictures of Frank and the father came up, and the DPO Uran division swung into action, arrested the father. By this time, Frank had escaped from the house through en route to Calabar. Some of his relations, knowing fully well that the father is a bit ill, came to speak about the father to say, let them assist. The DPO, and who happens to be the SP that Juan David, who then is claiming is a police officer who conspired with Frank, was brought into the picture, and he joined the cousins to call him and talk to him to come back. Because Frank kept denying that, he first denied that he did not even see the girl at all. But later, he said he did not know anything about the girl. He was convinced by the DPO and all and the cousins to come back, and he came back through Oron for Calabar, and he was brought to the police station eventually. At this point, he was still denying. He kept denying, and at the end of the day, under serious questioning, he broke down and confessed to having killed the young girl. This made the case to change from anti-kidnapping to homicide department, which investigates murder. Immediately, he led police officers to the scene where they saw the shallow grave, and the body of the deceased, may her soul rest in peace, was exhumed. It was obvious that there was a struggle. I'm not surprised that Frank said, okay, he had kind of knowledge of her at the point, but I'm not surprised there were marks of violence on her abdomen and part of her head, which resulted in the death. The body was taken up and sent to the mortuary for autopsy. An autopsy has been done. I'm sad to announce that the body has been committed to Mother Earth today. At the end of the day, the social media has gone gaga, a lot of stories. It's even said that maybe Frank belongs to the group of ritualists or people who harvest body parts to sell. We all know where he was arrested. He does not even have the facilities to keep body parts, because if you want to harvest body parts and sell, from my little understanding of medicine, it must be kept under some condition. But such things don't exist there. And it was said that a lot of bones, a lot of shallow graves were found in the compound, which investigation has not found to be so. And that's why when I appeared on Arise Television, I asked the person who wrote that which bones, where did they find bones? At the end of the day, the investigation is still ongoing. We are not foreclosing anything. I will urge Nigerians, instead of going to the press or the media with unclarified or phony information, they should pass it on to the police. Police will investigate. We are still open to find out if it is true that Frank belongs to any body harvesting organization. The investigation is open. The case file will eventually go to DPP, and eventually the justice will take its course. It is pertinent that we should mention all this so that people are not misled. A discreet investigation is still ongoing. It's at its almost at its concluding stage, but we never close investigation until we go to court. So I'm still saying, I'm appealing to members of the public, if you have information on this issue, you don't have it, open to it. Frank is here. Frank is not there. His father is by his side there for complicity, accessory after the fact. And at the end of the day, we believe justice will take its course. Thank you very much. Well, let me answer that immediately. We are police officers. We don't base what we do on rumor. We were at the site. Police exhumed the body. If there are shallow graves there, the particular shallow grave that the neighbor was placed in was not more than 2 feet deep. And such a thing, we all know, even if you bury a goat 2 feet deep, after about 48 hours, the stench will not even allow you to, neighbors will know, somebody must know that something has happened there. I saw a BBC video, things that look like holes where they dug up yam, are referred to as shallow grave. There are no shallow graves anywhere. There are no bones anywhere. That is the truth. But if anybody can show me any shallow graves there, you should go and show me, but I know there are no shallow graves. We went through the ground properly. Thank you.
Let's have the next question. My name is
I'm interested in the result of the autopsy. The public will want to know at this time. What's the result of the
The cause of death has already been ascertained by the autopsy. It has been ascertained, and at the end of the day, by the time file our charges, you get to know it all. I want to tell you one thing. The police has nothing to gain by covering anything. We are not covering anything. I have never met a friend before. He's a young man. My last child is even older than him. So I have no business. This is a murder case. We are talking of a human life lost. I cannot conspire with him to school investigation in any form. It will become the way it is, and we are going to report it as it is.
Thank you, sir. Yes, as you sir. My name is Isaac Jebarai for the letter. Last week, the National Assembly, the House of Representatives, urged the General Police to bring the case to speak for supporters.
Yes.
Why is the subject still in your custody despite the
It's a straightforward case. very straightforward case. My headquarters have asked for a report, which we have done. We are Nigerian police, but we use officers. There is no difference between an officer in force CID and state CID and even in the division. We all had the same training. Mother is mother. The same principles guard the investigation. They have not asked me to transfer after I have sent the report. If they ask, it's even still open now. But the IG, in his infinite wisdom, did not find a need for it because at the end of the day, we are on the right course.
Yes, please, we are done. Thank you. We will not listen to us. The CP has his closing remarks, but we are done with the question. Don't forget yourself.
Now, I thought that we were together.
Stop.
Why did you kill her?
Let us know what happened on that day.
It was audible.
What happened was that she came for a supposed job interview, which I used reverse psychology on. I asked her whether she can work in
the
farm.
We are not talking.
I asked her whether she can work in the farm where hard drugs are kept. I asked her whether she can work in the farm where hard drugs are kept as a secretary. And she said that she can, that she's ready to do the job. So when she came, I revealed to her that this farm doesn't exist. There's nothing, there's no farm like that. It was just a hoax. So then I told her that before she leaves that I would like to have sex with her. And she agreed, but she gave a condition that I should use a condom, which I did, and while I removed the condom, she became furious and she took the nearby stabilizer to hit me on my head, and then she hit my left ring finger and tried to reach for the phone, screaming, tried to reach for the phone. So while I was bleeding, in a bit to stop her, I used the stabilizer to tap. And when I hit her, she fell and started bleeding. Then after she died.
So where did she hit you?
On my phone.
Where is the wound?
What did you do?
You don't have.
How come? You said she agreed to have sex with you and use a condom. And then all of a sudden she started to attack you. How did it happen?
I said that while I was about removing the condom, she became furious.
Why did you want to remove the condom?
Yeah.
Why did you want to remove the condom?
You injured her on her head. And what do you use to hit her?
What did you use to hit her?
The same stabilizer that she used to.
At what point was she screaming for help?
When I tried to remove the condom.
But you didn't use only stabilizer, you used something else. Say
it. That was an iron, pressing iron.
Where did you use to hit? Where did you hit her?
On her abdomen, where she was fighting. So the only way I could stop her was
no hand. Which hand? Was she your first victim?
Yeah.
So how many have you killed in that process?
I've not killed anyone.
Okay. You say she was not your first. How many victims have fallen? How many girls, women, have you done that to? Whether they died or they did not die. How many so far?
The same reverse
side. Yeah. How many?
All reverse or reverse?
About six.
What of that NYC shoes you have?
The NYC shoes is shoe my mom used when she was in NYC that we used for farming. The shoe is used for farming in the house. It's not a copper shoe. It's not as if a copper came.
How did your father assist you in this case?
He did not assist me.
Do you live in that house?
So who helped you to bury her? Did you hypnotize her with any substance?
No. There's a number of exercise books and textbooks that are in that compound. Who owns them?
Those books. Exercise books. Those nursery and primary and secondary school exercise books are owned by I and my sisters.
There are several names on them. None of it is your own name. Who are those people? Those names are not yours.
Several names. Different names.
There are no different names on them.
Absolutely,
if you open them, you see either my name or my sister's name.
How about the red gown? The red gown in the room. In the room. Who owns it? There's a red gown in the room. In one of the rooms. Yes.
Why did you go into it?
What's your level of education?
I'm a university student.
What class are you reading? What level?
Which university?
Did you graduate?
What subject? What level?
Public administration.
What level?
Yeah.
How old are you?
20 years.
Please, what's your relationship with Kufre Fiong?
Kufre Fiong is my cousin.
And how did he help in this whole thing?
You called him on that day. What's the subject of conversation you have with him?
That was when I was coming back from Calabar. Because initially in the morning I went to Calabar. So while I was coming back, I need to submit myself to the police. It was the one that picked me up together with the DPO.
What's your conversation with him? What were you discussing?
Now, how do you feel about what has happened? Hello, dear.
My conversation with him was very short and simple. He texted me the number of the DPO of Iran that I called him when I arrived with you. So I called the DPO of Iran when I arrived with you. And then I met with them and they picked me. They picked me in
where did they pick you?
At Shelter Afrik Junction.
When you kill her, why do you go and dock a grave to Lubera? Why not take it to the police or report to the police that Jumbara died in your house?
I was very scared to do that because I thought maybe the whole scenario would be
suspicious too. So in India, what was your motive for you to ask her to come to get the job? What was your motive? What was in your mind? Initially,
I used reverse psychology because I've had very bad experiences with girls and prostitutes. So I used reverse psychology and I asked her whether she can work in a farm where hard drugs are kept, and she accepted. She even told me that she's marijuana and cocaine. So I felt that's the best way to revenge on prostitutes and run girls.
Have you been patronizing prostitutes?
No, I used to.
Now, how do you feel about what you've done? What you've done before the whole war? How do you feel?
I'm not happy about it. I believe that the commissioner of police is working with men and he has assured Nigerians, has assured our private friends and the entire world that justice
was your father around when this thing occurred? Your father been not there when this thing happened?
No, he wasn't around.
How about your sister?
Is she involved?
Are you remorseful?
Yes,
but you don't sound and look remorseful.
You said if you don't, you said justice should prevail. Now, if that justice means
taking your life,
will you readily agree to look to your
life?
Were you in love with the girl?
No.
Where are you from?
Please, you don't have business here. Leave, I beg.
Where are you from? Please, let's keep quiet now.
Chief, were you aware of you? What your son?
I wasn't aware. I'm not happy about it.
It's fine. I can't get him. Please get him.
I wasn't aware.
So, at what point do you know about this issue? At what point?
I was asked to recall him when a police came to my compound, checked the compound, they didn't say anything. So I was invited to come and make a statement at the Uran police station. I did. So I was asked to call him immediately. I now called him back. So when he now arrived, I was allowed to interact with him. He told me that he did something wrong and that he's sorry. I was blaming him. Why do you do this? We are not the only child. I have two other children and they are women. They are graduates. One is finishing, one is just starting.
if anybody does this to your sisters, would you like to say that? No. So he was very.
Were you in the house when this is?
I wasn't in. I went to town.
So is that your house, sir?
Yes, it's my compound.
Do you live there?
Yes, I live there.
It is reported that nobody has access, that Eba had access to that compound.
That's always locked.
It's always locked.
That is not true.
That's what the neighbor said.
That is not true. Well, that's what we have. We have a borehole in that house. All the people in the street, they fetch water from there. We have plenty of fruits and vegetables in that compound. We give out fruits free. So it's just unfortunate.
Well, yeah, wait, your son has been in family business.
No.
That you are involved.
I'm not
involved. He said he has had, he has taken advantage of over 6 girls. And you never for one.
And you stay in that house.
I'm not aware about that. The reason is I just relocated. From Abuja. I've not been around for 30 years. We've been living outside here. Because I've been retired. So it's not up to even 2 years before you relocate.
Now, where do you retire from?
As what?
Okay, from the ministry.
Which ministry?
Federal Ministry of Health.
As?
My director. Position?
Yes.
Okay, deputy director. So, once in a while, some other official assignment take me out, even though I've retired. Like, for instance, the health records record of Nigeria. You know, the age of that, our parasitical, because of supplementary supervision. So that's what takes me out. Then, if I'm not around, my other children, that are always around, especially during holidays, they are absolutely.
Okay, information goes in that initially you were arrested while they were still in search of your son or that life.
No,
did you give information to the police about whereabouts of
Ugak? Yes, immediately. I said, Ugak says he's going to Calabar, but now I should call him. So I called him back and he came back. It was when he now came back that they now asked me to go. And so they now say they are going to interrogate Ugak.
Everybody is asking for justice. And what we tend to understand by justice in murder case is a person should die. You also request for that justice.
Well, it depends on the system. I'm not happy about what my child has done. I don't even believe this can happen to me. After I send them to school, try to bring them up. Yeah, justice can be done if the system so permits.
Your son says Kufrefion played a very integral role in his arrest. You also say you come back to Calabar from Calabar. Which one should take? Your son said Kufrefion asked him to come back. You are now telling us you called your son to come from Calabar.
Yes, I called him when I was asked to come and make this statement. He was, you know, they brought a phone, showed me two pictures, said, who among these women? I said, this is my son. So as we're going to the police station, they say, since he has gone to that, I should recall him. I called him and
with your number?
Yes.
It's record of the number, dialing his phone over the past.
I didn't call his number, his phone was off. I called the sister as soon as Ugak
arrived.
Sir, who is calling to you?
Kufrefion is the son to my brother, one of the sons to my brother. This is my only son.
How many children do you
have? Three.
Frank Akpan.
Frank, that's how I'm.
Full name.
Yes.
But he has been that you've traded the business for years.
Okay.